Heat wave, then a hailstorm. Southeast Queensland is absolutely copping it at the moment. Nine weather expert Gary Youngbury is live on the Gold Coast. Gary, let's talk straight talk here. Is the worst of it now over?
Well, absolutely not. It's just the start, David, really, the start of thunderstorm season. I mean, we had about three consecutive days of extreme temperatures. It was Tuesday afternoon, very late in the day or evening when thunderstorms started to fire up, and there were several rounds into early hours of the morning. Tens of thousands of homes without power due to power lines being brought down from downdrafts from those thunderstorm cells. There was some very heavy rain, not a lot of hail due to temperatures being a little bit cooler early hours of the morning, but they fired up again yesterday afternoon, Brisbane's northern suburbs around the Sunshine Coast. And then as they pushed up into the Wide Bay region, up around Hervey Bay, there was giant hail. It was officially measured 10 centimetres in diameter, destructive winds and some very heavy rainfall. So that was basically day two of that. But, David, it's just the start of thunderstorm season here.
Yeah, really intense stuff. And those shots of the lightning is just incredible. What about other states? Are they in the firing line too, Gary?
Yeah, well, anywhere across eastern Australia, really, what we've got is heat building again through the central parts of our country. It will make its way back into the eastern states as we start to push into early next week. So southeast Queensland, basically, more heat building again, and it's only the early stages of summer, really. I think this summer is going to be a very volatile summer as far as thunderstorms go, and it's not just in Queensland, a large part of our country, David.
Yeah, good for people planning their holidays too, to bear that in mind when they're going to Queensland too. Thanks, Gary.
But it's time to take a look at the weather now. So let's have a look at Brisbane today. It was a much cooler day across the southeast, the city reaching 27 degrees at midday, 25 at Coolangatta. Toowoomba and the Sunshine Coast, 26 degrees. The warmest place was Oakey, 31 degrees. Looking at tomorrow's maps, troughs will maintain heat across the northern and central interior and into South Australia. They'll also trigger a few showers and storms in eastern Queensland. Looking at the capitals tomorrow, Sydney 23 degrees and partly cloudy, sunshine and 25 in Melbourne, 23 in Canberra, a scorcher in Adelaide 35 with a late cool change, Hobart should reach 19, partly cloudy for Perth, 35 in Darwin with a possible storm. Back home, Cairns can expect a sunny top of 34 degrees, 33 in Townsville, Hamilton Island 30 degrees, hot out west, Longreach 41 degrees, Charleville 34. Back on the coast, a possible storm in Yeppoon and Bundaberg, cloudy and 25 degrees in Maroochydore. In Brisbane tomorrow, a minimum of 19 overnight before a top of 25, just a 30% chance of a light shower. Looking further ahead, enjoy a few cooler days before the temperatures go back up next week. 27 on Sunday, we're back into the 30s come Monday, 32 Tuesday, 31 Wednesday, 33 Thursday.
Good evening. It's been a partly cloudy day with light to moderate southeasterly winds. Penrith was our warmest suburb, reaching a top of 24 degrees. Our other western suburbs were a touch cooler, 21 the top for Parramatta, Kellyville and Liverpool. It was 22 degrees at the city, 20 the top for Cronulla. Across the state and for inland areas, temperatures were around 5 to 10 degrees cooler than the December average. A huge range in temperatures too. Narrabri hitting a top of 29, but it was only 18 degrees in Bega. Tomorrow, and the heat will continue across the northern and central interior, troughs also triggering a few showers and storms for Queensland. Brisbane and Melbourne are heading for partly cloudy conditions, a top of 25 degrees. Well, the mercury will absolutely soar in Alice Springs, heading for a sweltering top of 42. And it'll be a mixed bag of weather across the state tomorrow as well. Sunny and 31 in Broken Hill, with just a top of 20 degrees for Wollongong. Sydney will be partly cloudy tomorrow with light to moderate southwesterly winds. A warning is also in place for large and powerful surf right the way down the coastline. Temperatures will be a couple of degrees below average. 23 the top for Kellyville, Campbelltown and Liverpool. The same in the city and 19 degrees in Cronulla. And looking ahead, and things are warming up, it'll be a sunny top of 27 degrees in Sydney on Sunday before a possible shower or two on Monday. But then the sunshine will return on Tuesday with a top of 26 degrees. And in our western, Sunday is shaping up to be an absolute cracker. Sunny, 32 degrees. It'll be warm on Monday too, but a slight chance of a shower. But the blue skies will be back on Tuesday in a top of 30 degrees. The rest of the week also looking pretty damn good as well. So finally, a burst of summer sun is on the way. Mark?
Hello again. It was nice to see a bit of sunshine on and off throughout the day. Even still, the city only made it to 17.6. Southerly winds capped daytime temperatures at 17, 18 and 19 around town. The Bellarine Peninsula had a few passing showers, but there wasn't a lot in them. Further out, temperatures were well below average at both ends of the day. Falls Creek got down to minus 5. Rather Glen went from being one of our coldest places overnight to equal warmest, climbing from a low of 3 to 20. 3 degrees. There was also up to 5 millimetres of showers in East Gippsland, but there's dry skies across the board now, and we can expect a beautiful Saturday morning. It'll be mostly sunny before a bit of patchy cloud in the afternoon. Sunday will be even warmer. It won't be nearly as pleasant though, with northerly winds strengthening ahead of the next change and scattered showers developing with possible storms in the afternoon and evening. They'll persist on Monday, and daytime temperatures will take a big hit again, then we'll remain under cool southwesterlies right through to this time next week. Taking a look elsewhere for tomorrow, Adelaide will easily be the hottest of the southern capitals. It's heading for 35 degrees before a late cool change. Brisbane and Perth will be 10 lower than that with 25. Sydney and Canberra are both heading for 23, but their overnight max minimums will be vastly different, 16 and 5. There's a partly cloudy top of 19 on the way for Hobart. Back home, we're in for another chilly night, dropping to single figures almost right throughout, and there's the chance of frost in the east. Then plenty of sunshine will give temperatures a boost, up into the low to mid-20s for most of southern Victoria. Hamilton should reach 25, while in the north, 30 degrees in Mildura will be our warmest, otherwise looking at the mid to high 20s, and it'll get a little windy through elevated parts tomorrow night. Here in Melbourne, it'll be calm and mostly sunny, a low of 5 on the way for Coldstream. The Mornington Peninsula should stay a little milder overnight than the rest, but not by much. Rosebud is forecast to dip to 9 degrees ahead of a top of 22 and warming up to 25 and 26 closer in. Geelong is heading for 23 degrees with lots of blue sky, a low of 8 in the city before a lovely mild top of 25 under gentle breezes. Then becoming very windy on Sunday, 26 degrees, 6 to 15 millimetres is expected from the late afternoon, and we could hear some rumbles of thunder. Monday is looking very similar with up to 15 millimetres again, gusty winds, the chance of a storm and a much cooler top of 18. 18 on Tuesday as well with a shower or two. Then it's a triple hit of 15 with Wednesday, Thursday and Friday all looking cloudy with some showers. But back to the good news, we've got an absolutely ripping day in store tomorrow. The city is heading for a mostly sunny top of 25. And for those lucky enough to be heading to Billy Joel at the G tomorrow, it's looking like a picture-perfect night, Alicia.
Well, it sure was a cloudy start to the day, but now a balmy evening out there, clear skies and just under 27 degrees at the moment. Our top today was just over 27 degrees, and overnight it dropped down to 12 degrees. Well, the cloud also cleared across the suburbs today, making for a warm, sunny afternoon, 27 at Mawson Lakes, 26 at Glenelg. A warm one in the north today, temperatures ranging from 38 at Coober Pedy to 26 in the Clare Valley. A little cooler in the south, Mount Gambier just cracking 20 degrees late today, but that was after a very cold start, down to 2. Now, 2 degrees at Narracourt this morning as well. That high pressure system continues to dominate our weather. It will drift across Tasmania tomorrow and the winds will swing around, bringing quite a jump in temperature. But that trough floating in from the west, well, that brings possible showers and a cool change on Sunday. If you're travelling for the weekend interstate, fine and partly cloudy right along the east coast, 25 for Brisbane and Melbourne, 23 for Sydney and Canberra, a stormy 35 through the top end.
Back at home tomorrow, look at those temperatures shooting up in the north. 42 degrees for Coober Pedy, 39 at Port Augusta, with just a little bit of cloud around. A warm one through the state south tomorrow too, most places in the low to mid 30s, except the lower southeast. Just a little cooler there, 27 for Mount Gambier, 29 for Narracourt. There are total fire bans in place tomorrow across a number of areas, including the Lower Eyre Peninsula and York Peninsula, where the fire danger rating is catastrophic. Also, Eastern Eyre Peninsula, Mid-North, and also Mount Lofty, I believe, where the rating is extreme. There's a strong wind warning in place tomorrow for the Spencer Gulf. On metro waters, winds are swinging around a bit, tending northwesterly at 15 knots, seas below a metre. A hot day and a warm evening across Adelaide tomorrow, cloud clearing during the day and warming up to tops in the mid-30s all across the board there. The city is heading for a top of 35 degrees, meaning a warm one for the test match. But that cool change will swing through early on Sunday morning, bringing a drop in temperature and a couple of showers too, possibly. A shower or two hanging around on Monday and Tuesday with a cooler top of 19 degrees there. Then on Wednesday, it should be pretty fine, 19 degrees Thursday, going for a cloudy 21 all the way up to 22 degrees this time next week.